Get ready to enter the Thrive Time Show.
We started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, and we'll show you how to get here. We started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, now we're here.
We started from the bottom, now we're on the top, teaching you the systems to get what we got. Colin Dixon's on the hooks, I break down the books. Z's bringing some wisdom and the good looks. As the father of five, that's why I'm a dive. So if you see my wife and kids, please tell them hi. It's the C&Z up on your radio. And now 3, 2, 1, here we go.
We started from the bottom, now we hit.
Thrive Nation, welcome back to your inspiration station. For people discovering us for the first time, my name is Clay Clark. I'm the former SBA Entrepreneur of the Year. I am in your ear to teach you that your success is, check it out, near. Your success is near. We are going to teach you how to do it. And to teach you the specific moves and the specific steps to start or grow a successful business, I've brought on a guy who's is really a recovering optometrist turned entrepreneur. He is Tulsa's tycoon. It's Dr. Robert Zellner. Sir, how are you?
I am fantastic, and it's so exciting. We're in our new slot.
We're in a new slot.
This is it. This is the first.
It's business
time. It's business time at lunchtime.
I'll tell you this. I talked to a thriver the other day. True story.
Yep.
I talked to a guy, and he goes, I am so excited about you shifting to the middle of the day. And I go, why? He goes, because a lot of times if I'm listening to Rush Limbaugh, I got to like turn it off because it's so divisive in the office.
Yeah.
And so, but you guys, I could listen to this. I mean, who could disagree with success?
True. And I'll tell you what, you know, Forbes says it, and we got to believe it, that 57% of you listening out there secretly want to start, you know, start your business, and you're just waiting for that person to kind of coach you up, give you some steps, give you some encouragement, give you the practical steps to do that. And you know what? You found us. They found us.
And Thrivers, listen to this. Today we're talking about an exciting subject. In fact, all week we are talking about this. Now, is this a pro-Donald Trump thing? Is this a pro? Are you guys pro?
Is this political?
No. This week's topic is the American dream is possible if you aren't watching TV 5 hours per day.
What are you talking about?
Well, I'm going to give an example.
Wait. That's the good thing about DVR is I don't even have to be home when my shows are on. I can come home and watch my shows any of the 5 hours of the day I want to. Huh? So there.
I'm going to give an example. This just came in. This just in, okay? There was an article written by David Hinckley that appeared in the New York Daily News titled, The Average American Watches 5 Hours of TV Per Day. And guess what it was about? People who watch TV 5 hours per day.
It's shocking.
And so I have a little notable quotable that I want to share with you, and this is just something that I it's kind of a paraphrase, but when you find yourself in a hole, stop digging.
Lou Holtz said that one time. I just thought that was brilliant.
So, Thrivers, listen. Some of you right now, the tip of the day is, listen, the American dream is possible if I don't what? So I want you to go ahead and get out a sheet of paper and just, my American dream is possible if I quit doing what? And I have found that the majority of business fires are started by entrepreneurs who carry the matches in their own pocket, and they just set themselves on fire all the time.
Kerosene in the other one, right?
Yeah. So I'm going to give you some examples right now of some things that are wealth-destroying activities. I'm going to kind of go through them one by one, and Z, I'd like to get your take on these things.
Absolutely. That's what I'm here. You're the play-by-play, and I'm the color commentary of your business education.
So move number one absolutely destroy your chances of success.
All right.
One is constantly not providing enough time to get something done. So you have a big dream. I want to write a book. I want to start a business. I want to update my social media, whatever you want to do, but not blocking off enough time. Because entrepreneurs kind of operate in this entrepreneur time where we feel like we can get everything done real fast.
Yep.
And then we realize, oh no, this is going to take 4 hours. So talk to me about time blocking and how why is it so important that an entrepreneur who's motivated is realistic about how long things are going to take to get done?
I'm going to go a step further.
Oh no.
And we may fight over this. We haven't had a good fight in probably a week and a half.
It's been a long time since we've had a good fight. We used to fight really big back in the 40s, but now.
I like when that guy shows up every now and then.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah. So I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to take it a step further. I'm going to go a little step deeper into the mojo of dojo, the dojo of mojo, okay?
You're going into that Tony Robbins deep stuff.
Yeah, I'm going to get the coals out there so you can walk on, okay? And that is choosing choosing what's even worth your time to spend time on. Because you said to yourself, oh, we got to block off time that's important. And that's the thing. That is, I think, one of the things that have I've done well in my life. I'm just going to say it. I've done well in my life. And that is the things that aren't important, I don't give them any time.
Okay, wait a minute. Today is an example, and I want you to coach the Thrivers through how you would handle this. This just happened on my cell phone. I pulled your brother aside. Sam, one of our producers, I pulled your brother aside to tell him this, because it was like a person reaches out to me and says, I want you to coach me. I really want you to help me grow my business. And I explained to them, that's not a thing. We have a coaching program through Thrive 15, which is awesome. And we have workshops, and we have an online school, but I cannot work with you. And they said, yeah, but you're working with my friend. And I said, yeah, but your friend is sort of like grandfathered in. I've worked with that client for 9 years. And yeah, I work with them, but it's not a thing. I can't work with you. Then they respond with almost an attack.
You're listening to the Thrive Time Show on Talk Radio 1170.
And they say, I remember that you started your business in your dorm room, and now you don't have time for people like me. And I go, listen, you and I have invested millions of dollars to build an online school.
We
have unbelievable workshops. We have an unbelievable coaching program, which, oh, by the way, thousands of people love. And, oh, by the way, it's written about in Forbes. It's a great program.
Yes.
And this person is upset that I would not meet with them. And I said, hey, you know what? I appreciate you. I know we disagree, but... And then the F-bomb came. They dropped an F-bomb. They're like, are you effing kidding me?
Uh-oh.
And so I decided, and this just happened just moments before you and I talked on the way here today. I go, this is not going to work out. 15 years ago, I probably would have lost my mind and continued arguing with this person for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Coach the Thrivers through right now. What are some of the things that people are getting stuck on and wasting huge amounts of time? What are they doing? What are people wasting their time on?
You know, there's a quote that was told to me years ago that I just loved. And that is, a lion, you know, I don't know if you've ever been to Africa. You've been to the zoo, right?
Yeah, I've been to the zoo.
Yeah, so the...
I love the meerkats.
The lion, the most... You're the king of the beast. Large predator.
Yeah, massive roar.
Massive roar. Yeah, the big mane and all that. They cannot survive on eating chipmunks.
Can you repeat that?
Well, the lion, one of the largest cat predators in the world, can't survive on eating chipmunks. Now, what does that mean?
Are you getting what I would call philosophical right about now?
Yes, I am. And that is the energy that he would extend to chase down, catch a chipmunk, and then devour it. He doesn't get enough calories and protein from the actual little chipmunk that's sustainable. So what I mean by that is I see it over and over and over. People get stuck with, you know, doing the little things, working on their business. I mean, working in their business instead of on their business. Now, specifically, what are those time wasters? Well, a lot of people, those time wasters are doing the little small piddly things around the office. You know, for me, you know, the time wasters were over obsessing about maybe an ad that I was going to do, and just really spending an inordinate amount of time on, is that the right color font? Is that the right thing? Is this here? Is that? And by the time I look up, I've spent an hour on re-editing something I've edited now 3 times. And I'm like, just run the thing already. You know, a lot of people are waiting for something to be perfect in their business before they sell it, before they display it, before they go out there and market it.
I'm going to tell you another time-wasting activity that I see a lot of entrepreneurs doing, and I've coached with hundreds and actually thousands of entrepreneurs. The one I see is the attempt to make everyone happy.
Oh.
The attempt to...
Well, you want them all to like you.
You want every meeting to end. You're the boss. And
yeah.
It's you and 4 employees, you and 8 employees. And you want everyone to come to a consensus. You're running it like a democracy and not a totalitarian, a benevolent totalitarian regime. But you're wanting everyone to agree and everything to be copacetic and we're on the same page before you wrap up the meeting.
You know, I was once a part of a business that had a 4-hour meeting every week.
Four hours
of every week.
Oh boy.
Now you think about this, those listening out there, you think, oh, that's smart. You know, every week we're going to get together for 4 hours and we're going to talk about all the things we want to do this week. And then we get all the things done from last week for 4 hours, you know. And if you think about this right now, I'm going to tell you something. Most of your employees are on a 40-hour work week and mentally. You got a couple superstars that are going to put in their 50, 60, 70, 80. And you as the owner of the store or the office or the business, you're going to put in like a gajillion hours because you're committed and you have to. And that's what you're going to do. That's what you signed up for in entrepreneurship, right? I love the line. You get to pick the 80 hours you get to work as an entrepreneur.
Love
Sure. Yeah. But if you're meeting for 4 hours a week, that's 10%. And the, guess what? While they're sitting on their rear ends, listening to you up there pontificate about, you know, the teamwork and the direction of the business and the excellence of everything and the urgency of this particular project, you've now wasted 10% of your production time in a meeting. And that's what I see. So many businesses over meet. It wears me out. I'm like, is there anything productive to say? Okay, then get back to work. You know, right. Is there anything we need to talk about? Then get back to work.
So if you're listening right now and you are one, you are wasting time on things you shouldn't be doing. That's you need to stop that. Two, if you're wasting time trying to have all these meetings to get everyone on the same page and you're constantly meeting, there is a place to have a meeting where you confirm what needs to be done and did you do it? That's kind of the point of a meeting with a little bit of motivation in there, but you don't want to spend hours and hours. And another big time wasting activity that I see people doing is doing things that are proven not to work. And drivers, if you're listening right now, we're going to talk to you about this coming up after the break. But if you have found yourself where you're loyal to dysfunction,
yeah,
and you're going, well, I'll tell you what we always do at Roy's Plumbing, what we always do is I'm Roy, and I always put every toilet in there myself. I install every toilet. I install every sink. Make sure that I actually personally polish every wrench. I answer every phone call because it's Roy's Plumbing.
My name's on the truck. It's on the van.
Well, it's Roy's Plumbing LLC, technically.
Well, my name's on there.
That's what I mean. So I do is it, and I'm gonna, and you're just loyal to that consistency of just, I do the same thing, and it doesn't work, but I'm consistent to it. That is an area where a lot of people get stuck. And so when we get back, Dr. Zellner, former optometrist, he's still an optometrist, but he's a recovering optometrist turned entrepreneur and tycoon. He owns an auction. He's invested in a bank.
A
no, you have. You've done great.
I'm Google that.
Yeah, and by the way, he's done great. He has a very, very successful thoroughbred breeding facility. The guy's just done awesome. And he's going to be teaching you kind of how to get out of that cycle of dysfunction when we come back on the Thrive Time Show. All right, Thrive Nation, welcome back to the Thrive Time Show, and you are listening right now to Tulsa's only local business radio show. If you've been just hoping, wishing, and praying for some kind of mentorship or some, you want like a ray of light, you are in for a treat because I am your pasty male. I'm so white. I have so little pigment that I almost glow at night. And I am here to teach you how to start and grow a successful business. My name is Clay Clark. I'm the former SBA Entrepreneur of the Year. And I tell you what, we have a guy, he's the co-host of the show. And he is an entrepreneur who he started off, by the way, working for somebody. Then he started his own business, Dr. Robert Zellner and Associates. Then Dr. Z, what was the next business that you went to after the optometry clinic?
Auto auction.
You went to the auto auction.
Uh-huh.
Then after having success with the auto auction, Z66AA.com, what was the next thing?
I started a sleep center, diagnostic sleep center, Dr. Z's sleep center. Get it? A lot of Z's in there.
And when did you decide to get involved in the bank and kind of serve on the board there? When was that?
Well, you know, the bank is probably one. It's the only business that I'm involved in. I don't have the majority of because it's so highly regulated. And I found a great guy and we decided to go. And then we put together a team where no one had full control over it. And, you know, all of us were, you know, roughly 5 to 10%, and we got a bunch of great business guys in Tulsa together. We went and bought a bank and rebranded it, and now we're growing it and having a lot of fun. I was on the board there for a while,
yeah,
but I figured out I'm not cut out to be a banker guy. I'm not. Well, the thing about it is that bankers love
to say.
And if you're listening out there and you're a banker or you've been to a banker, they love to say
no.
And I would often kick open the door. They'd be having these high level, you know, committees on whether they're going to approve this loan or not. And I just open the door and just scream, "Say yes!" and run off before they could, you know, fuss at me. You know.
So what we're doing, Thrivers, is we're talking today. Today's theme is the American dream is possible.
Yes.
If you're not watching 5 hours of TV per day, aka wasting your time.
Yeah.
And before we left, we were talking about a lot of entrepreneurs who are wasting their time doing things that are proven not to produce success. And I'll give you an example. If I could write a letter back to my former self, I was 14 years old.
Okay.
Got my first business going, and I was selling t-shirts, okay?
Oh, yeah.
And this company was called C&G DJ Service and t-shirts.
And t-shirts.
Okay. And G was a guy named Mark Haugen, and on a dare, he shaved a G into his chest because he had so much chest hair.
And therefore became G.
C&G DJ Service and t-shirt printing. And that was kind of the combo.
Yeah.
And I personally pressed every shirt. And by the way, right behind you, that's the t-shirt press. right behind you. That there, you see right there? Boom. The big blue thing. There it is. Oh, wow. You have the megaphone now, too.
I have the megaphone.
That megaphone works, by the way. It's live. It's hot.
Oh, good.
You can use it anytime. If you're on Facebook Live, you just hit that trigger.
Hello.
There it is. This just did. Yeah.
We're in the man cave.
And you're over there. We're in the man cave. And there's the t-shirt press. I bought that thing for a couple $1,000s back in the day, and you'd print t-shirts on that. And that was my first business. And I prided myself on I printed every shirt and designed every shirt.
I bet you're pretty good at it by the end of every day. Yeah.
And I would not stop.
Yeah.
I remember my dad looks up at me one time, and my dad wasn't very entrepreneurial, but my dad was kind of a common sense guy. And my dad and I'm not kidding, I sold like 400 t-shirts to a swim team, and we're pressing t-shirts in the basement all night in Minnesota. And my dad goes, "Do you know if we don't sleep at all this weekend, we will barely finish?" And I'm like, it's awesome.
It's great.
And so
swim team needs their t-shirts, Dad.
I was totally committed to it. I thought it was awesome. I'm getting $2,000 to work all weekend. And eventually, though, I had to look up and go, okay, this isn't going to be the path to financial success. So, Z, where do you see a lot of entrepreneurs getting stuck doing the same thing over and over that does not work?
They're time wasting. You know, I think that's one of the biggest killers of entrepreneurs is that they get down those little rabbit trails, and next thing you know, they're deep in the forest on this little rabbit trail looking up going, have I done anything productive today? And here's what you have to do. If you're an entrepreneur out there, you've got to, and this is going to be old school. Can I go old school?
I would prefer if you would go old school. We want you to go old school, and please reference Belichick and Brady.
I'm a grandfather now, so technically I can pull the old school card out. I became one on Thanksgiving just last week.
Ladies and gentlemen, Father Time is on the show tonight.
Yes, I tell you what, someone bring me my walker. Okay, so here's the deal. You have to have your priority list. I'm telling you, you have to have your priority list. Do you just think about it? No. You write that down. What is the number one thing you need to get done for your business next? Yes. I'm not talking about, by the end of the year, I want to have a new
quarter three of 2018, I plan to be.
You're listening to the Thrive Time Show on Talk Radio 1170.
So what you do now is you write down what's the next thing you need to do for your business. Whatever it is, fill in that blank. What is it? And be purposeful about it, okay? Now, is that something that only you can do?
Ooh.
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 Ooh. Ooh. Okay, it is something only you can do. And guess what? Anything that you're spending your time on today that is not working to get that accomplished is a time waster.
Mm.
You want to say that again? Anything you're doing today that doesn't accomplish that number one goal that you need to do next for your business is time wasting.
But Z, I love to update my Twitter. I love it because when I do it, I hit the tweet button. There's like four or five people that will share it. And I love the whole retweet deal.
I see how many likes I get on the picture. You know,
I've got 7,000 likes and I got $2,000 in the bank. But I love the likes.
I love the likes. Yeah, if you've got more likes in your thing, you've got money in the bank. Stop doing Facebook or Instagram or whatever you're doing. So, and you may say to yourself, yeah, but, you know, I know it's my number one thing to do, but, you know, I get just busy with all this other stuff. Stop it. Say no. You've got to learn how to say no.
And Z, this show, we're here to teach you the specific things that are going to help you be successful as an entrepreneur. And I'm going to say something up next that's a little bit offensive. And I'm going to go ahead and just kind of step into it lightly, okay?
Because
this is a thing that makes the American dream not possible for you.
Okay.
The next move, okay? Dressing like an idiot before you can. Work with me. Dressing like an idiot before you can. So work with me. If you are in a band.
Okay. I'm in a band.
You're a musician.
I'm a musician.
You
have
to dress the part. How does a bass player look? I don't know. You need to dress like a bass player. Go Google your favorite band. Dress like the bass player. If you're a doctor, when you're meeting with patients back in the day, you have to dress like a doctor if you're a doctor.
I was very doctorly back in the day when I met with those patients.
If you're a baseball player, you want to wear the uniform. For some reason, the managers still wear the uniform.
Why is that the coach?
They're not going to rush out there and play.
Yeah, you're batting. Batting now.
It's like an overweight man wearing a baseball jersey in his 60s. It's so weird. Anyway, I'm saying this, but the thing, it would be weird if you showed up to a baseball game as a baseball player wearing a basketball uniform. It just wouldn't make any sense.
It'd be kind
of
weird.
So here's the thing is, Thrivers, many of you right now are not branding and or dressing to impress. You're not dressing for the way you want to be addressed. And what happens is, people are like, bro, I got this sweet new tattoo on my neck, and I'm going to get one more on my face like Mike Tyson. Well, Mike Tyson can get a tattoo tattoo on his face because he's Mike Tyson.
Because he's Mike Tyson.
I mean, people will pay him literally in Vegas to talk about how he's Mike Tyson. But for you, if you're the struggling entrepreneur just trying to get the thing off the ground, baby, you've got a brand. And see, you always talk about how squirrels, how squirrels are great branders. When we get back, we're going to be talking about branding, okay? And it's not so much about dressing the way you want to be addressed or dressing for success. It's about branding. It's about looking the part. Because if not, you're going to waste a lot of time. You get that big meeting and people write you off before you even open your mouth.
You see, the thing is, you're sitting probably at Oklahoma Joe's having your burnt ends and your baked beans, and you're sitting there and you got us on your little tablet and you're listening to us in your earbuds because you didn't want to miss the show over lunch, right? And when we get back, I'm going to tell you a great dress for unsuccess story about Clay Clark. You don't want to miss it. You don't want to miss it.
All right, Tulsa, Green Country, welcome back. Many Oklahomies are listening during your lunch day, and you want the knowledge in the worst way. You're going, hey, listen, I want to be successful. I want to start a successful business, and I want to do, I know you guys have done it. Please teach me how. My name is Clay Clark. I'm the former SBA Entrepreneur of the Year. I'm joined here with Dr. Robert Zellner, and I was a guy who, oh, by the way, I did get kicked out of college writing a parody song about my school's president. And there was a time, and you talked about it before the break a little bit, where I did not dress to impress or the way that I wanted to be addressed. I dressed like I was trying to digress. And I pass it over to you now. You just tell a story.
Oh, that's right. Dr. Robert Zellner here. I'm an entrepreneur trapped in an optometrist body. And we're, listen, everybody listening out there, we're not trying to hide from you. I know the last couple of months we were from 5 to 7, you know, every day, Monday through Friday. And now they've slipped us down the old time clock. And now we're from noon to 2. So instead of dinner time, we're now lunchtime.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So when you're in your car driving to lunch, you're going over to Arby's, you're going to Oklahoma Joe's, you're going over to the Delicatessen, and now you can kick us on and listen to us. Or if you're at your office, just turn on Facebook Live. You can actually watch us because we are in what is perhaps one of the world's best man caves. It's really very cool.
It was inspired by you.
But I'll tell you what, here's what happened. Years ago, we had this lovely young lady work for us. Her name was Vanessa.
Oh, she's beautiful.
And she was just like apple pie. I mean, it was just Americana. You know, every time she walked by, a little rainbow would show up. Just sweet as could be, right?
Yeah.
And then she had this kind of a creepy dude come by the office and kind of hang out day after day after day. And someone said to me, I said, who's that creepy dude? And they said, I think that's Vanessa's husband. And it just went through the office like wildfire. And like a wildfire. Like dry leaves just going up in flames.
I'm glad I don't know who this Vanessa is, and I'm glad I don't know who this husband was, because this sounds like a sad story.
No, it was you.
No!
These baggy pants, looped earrings, this clothes that didn't fit, looked like they were like hand-me-downs from the Jolly Green Giants, you know? kind of walking around, kind of like, you know, like the punk, you know, and just kind of watching and creeping and looking at everything.
I was keeping it real.
Yeah, you give it a real bad is what you were doing. And then you started this company, you know, and it's really good because you had a guy mentor you up and say, dude, look how you're dressing. You're not buying, you're selling. And there's a big, big difference in the way you dress when you're buying or you're selling.
So what are you talking about? What does that mean?
Well, I'll tell you, here's the deal. When you're buying, you can dress however you want. You can wear a soccer jersey. You can wear jeans. You can wear these little UGG shoes I've got on right now. They're comfortable this time of year, by the way.
Yeah.
You could do that when you're buying, because the person selling to you is trying to impress you. You're not trying to impress them because they're wanting you to buy what they have. Now, if you're selling, and everybody out there, when you start your business, guess what? Spoiler report right here. You're selling. You're selling something. You're selling a widget, a thing, a service, a product, something that you've handcrafted in the basement of your home over the weekend, right? And you're selling. And you have to look the part. You can't dress like you got hand-me-downs from the Jolly Green Giant. You can't have, you know, all this, you know, stuff, earrings and whatnot. I mean, I think the earrings may be a little bit more appropriate if you're a woman, obviously selling.
And by the way, if you're listening right now and you're an entrepreneur and you're wearing earrings and you're successful, that's fine. What we're trying to say to you, we're trying to help you, is that, listen, we don't want you to waste time. The American dream is absolutely possible, but you can't create your own hurdles. You can't create problems for yourself. The idea is let's have success as fast as possible. And Z, I have some mystic statistics that I'm going to read off for you. And the profundity of these, it never ceases to escape me. It never ceases to amaze me. It's amazing. This is one. 88% of wealthy people are reading 30 minutes or more each day for education or career reasons versus 2% of the poor. By the way, we're broadcasting from the man cave, and so my cat wants to move into the next room there, so he's very very focused on this idea. But 88% of wealthy are reading 30 minutes or more each day for education or career or career reasons versus 2% of the poor. Z, why are wealthy people reading all the time, and why are poor people saying, I don't have time for that?
Because they're always going to school. What does that mean? That means they're always increasing their learning. But that's learning? Yes. You know, reading books. I mean, I tell you what, someone said to me one time, they said, listen, I went to this thing and it was like an hour long thing, but I learned one good thing out of it, a little pearl, a little nugget. And I'm telling you what, folks, that's what an entrepreneur is constantly seeking to do. When you start your business, the day you say, well, I got this all figured out, I know it all. It's no big deal. I got this. This is easy button done. You know what? That's the day that you're going to start sliding.
This just did another mystic statistic. These are things that are keeping you from being successful, because the American dream is possible, but you got to quit doing it.
It's possible.
6% of wealthy say what's on their mind versus 69% of the poor. Again, this is in Tom Corley's book. By the way, it's cited on Dave Ramsey's website. It's Habits of the Rich. He says 6% of wealthy are saying, I say what's on my mind. 69% of poor are like, 69% of the poor people are going, I keep it real. I'll tell you how it is.
Yeah.
See, why is that an issue?
Well, it is an issue because I tell you what you're doing is you're, if you're just saying what's on your mind, you're not thinking about it. Because half the things, or actually probably what, 94% of the things you're thinking, you shouldn't say.
Oh, no.
You shouldn't say. You've got to process these things, and that's what happens. Effective people and successful people think about things, and they say things that are only necessary to be said. It's not like I'm going around like a, it's kind of like this Facebook now. You know, it's kind of like a social media now. Oh, yeah. Everybody's posting everything about their life.
See, I'm out
24/7.
I'm out for salad right now, and I took a picture of my salad. This is me with my salad, and this is me with myself having my salad.
Should I use the Parmesan peppercorn ranch or the vinaigrette?
Asking random people questions about your food choices at lunch.
Like either one, so I'll know which salad dressing to use today at lunch, because I'm stuck.
Now, Thrivers, when we come back, we're going to be talking about how lifelong education is absolutely essential if you want to become successful. Stay tuned. All right, Thrive Nation, welcome back to your inspiration station. You could be on the other channel listening to politics. You could be learning about the state of the economy. These are things that are important to know. But once you know it, you got to ask yourself, how much more do I need to know before I realize that I do not have the ability to do anything other than to cast a vote and or run for office? Okay, so now you're going, hey, I am looking to turn my dreams into reality. I'd actually like to learn some things that I can practically implement in my own life, and that is what the Thrive Time Show is all about. My name is Clay Clark. I'm the SBA Entrepreneur of the Year. I'm honored to be here with you on today's radio broadcast, and as always, we have the co-host with the Mo-Ost. It's Dr. Robert Zellner in the house. This guy is an entrepreneur who's been trapped mercilessly inside an optometrist body. Sir, how are you?
I am fantastic on this. Happy Monday. And this is our new little home. This is our new home from 12 to 2 on AM 1170 Talk Radio. And we are so excited that you are listening to us, because we are going to do our best.
We're going to do our best
to bring you practical business tips so that you can go from being an entrepreneur, and that's our goal. And I tell you what, there's a fail rate of business startups of 80%.
According to Forbes.
Yeah, and that's a thing. So we're going to try, for those of you listening to our show, we're going to take that 80% fail rate, and we're going to take it down to, our goal is 0%.
Yeah.
Zero.
That's our goal.
That's a number, zero. Okay? And so we're going to try to, through our mistakes,
yep,
through our mentorship, trips, from the things we've done right, the things we've done wrong, and things we've learned along the way. We're here to just bear ourselves open in front of you. Just bear.
Now, here's the thing is, Thrivers, listen to this. A lot of times you go to a speaking event, and they have an entrepreneur who gets up there to speak, and he's talking to you about, well, these are the 7 ways that I achieve success, and this is, I wasn't born with a silver spoon, but now I only use silver spoons, if you know what I mean, you know. And so we're talking today about the American dream, and the American dream is absolutely possible. It is. But I want to encourage you to look this up. Google this tonight. CNN Money reported that 59% of Americans no longer believe that the American dream is possible.
Oh, Billy!
And I'm saying I disagree with 59% of Americans. I'm going to tell you why. Because there's another statistic I'm going to give you. It says 86% of wealthy believe in lifelong education and self-improvement versus 5% of the poor. Where did I get that? That's from Tom Corley, his book, Habits of the Rich. Z, I want you to unpack the importance of ongoing education and why so many wealthy people are absolutely, almost all wealthy people, by the way, are committed to ongoing education.
I tell you what, because the world is a-changing. And if you think the technology that you're to surround yourself with right now is going to be the same technology you surround yourself with in 10 years, you're going, that's crazy. So why is it that we're always learning about all the new gadgets and stuff and fun things we can update our social media with the new iPhone or the new Samsung, you know, kind of thing. And then you say to yourself, the thing that's the most important, that is the education of, so you can help run your business, is so important. And that stat right there is just so telling. And when you see people that have kind of given up, stop learning, stop doing the extra they need to do to figure something out, those are the ones that their businesses are going to fail. And you can just see that. Now, we believe in it so much, Clay. A couple of years ago, you came and Shark Tanked me on this idea of building a business school online. Mm. You know, I remember going through school. Remember this, Clay? You went through school.
Oh, yeah.
And you had a favorite teacher. You may not have even liked the subject. Remember those days?
I did. I'll tell you what. Miss Jansen was my teacher.
Oh, yeah. Mrs. Jansen. What'd she teach?
She was an English teacher, and she taught me the love of reading for the first time.
And it just made it come alive.
It did. And I wasn't even interested in the books.
Yeah, exactly. And you said to yourself, this lady has my attention. I want to do well in this class. I want to impress her. And she just said there's something magical about the way she's up there teaching and the way she pours herself into it. And then you go to the next class, and that teacher's like, wow. And you're like,
that was Mr. Smith, my history teacher.
Yeah, and you're just like, give me a gun. I'm going to buy a bullet and borrow a gun. You're
to quote
like,
Mr. Smith, I want to tell you, to quote Mr. Smith, he goes, all right, today we're running, this is a true memory. He goes, all right, today we're talking about who gives a crap, and I got to be honest with you, I'm just going to give you the handout, and you memorize all the crap, and next week you're going to forget all the crap, and I'm going to keep doing this, and just whatever, and I'm not kidding, and he loved girls basketball, he coached girls basketball, but he literally said, today we're learning who gives a crap.
You're listening to the Thrive Time Show on Talk Radio 11.
And he says, you're going to have to memorize some things that you're going to forget by next week. And I'm going to give you some more crap. So here's the study guide.
Here's the stuff. Well, what we did with Thrive15.com is we gathered up all the Miss Jansons.
Yes.
And all the Mr. Smiths, we said, no, thank you.
No, thank you.
And what we did is we sat them down in their area of expertise and we filmed them in a fun way. We called it edutainment.
Yes, the merging of entertainment and education.
And then what we did is we made them in kind of bite-sized morsels,
yeah,
i.e. 15 minutes plus or minus.
Yeah.
And we streamed them live like a Netflix of business excellence coaching school.
As an example, there is a man by the name of Michael Levine.
All right.
Who is dyslexic.
Yep.
He cannot read the way that most people can. By the way, he still to this day, if you text him, he can't read it.
Wow.
But he's a New York Times, work with me, a New York Times best-selling author. And he represented, I'm going to read him off, and I want you to Google this, Thrivers, and see if I'm making this up. He was the PR consultant for Michael Jackson. For Prince. By the way, Prince and Michael Jackson both could do the So Michael Jackson and Prince. Then he goes on to be the PR guy for, I don't know, Pizza Hut.
That's a thing.
Nike. This guy is like an unbelievable entrepreneur. And by the way, he's one of the top public relations consultants in the world. We got him on video. We asked him specifically, what is your system? And you could pay him currently. You could pay the guy $12,000, $14,000, $15,000 a month. and sign a contract. By the way, that's what Nike does. Or you could pay $19 a month to learn his moves on Thrive15.com. It's crazy.
Well, we're that passionate about education. And I love the tagline that you say that we are the business school without the BS. I just love that. And the Forbes article that came out and talked about how Thrive 15 was one of the top online education platforms there is out there.
You know, Z, recently it's kind of funny, the whole Forbes thing, but I remember as a kid I would read Forbes.
Yeah.
And just last month I got asked to start writing for those guys.
So that's why that's very cool. When your first article comes out?
It's going to be, well, in January I started. There's a thing called a coaches forum that I've been asked to be a part of.
And the coaches forum.
If you Google my name, Clay Clark, and then entrepreneur, you'll find the articles I've written for Entrepreneur Magazine. Or if you Google Clay Clark and Fast Company, you'll see the stuff in Fast Company. But the thing is, you and I, man, I'm just telling you, it's funny because we're Oklahomies and we're obsessed with teaching people practical tips. And so I have a success story I want to share right now.
Oh, please do.
We have a thriver, a guy that's a neat guy, and he is great at his craft in the medical profession. And what he was learning was more and more people are on Facebook. This just in. So he, as a medical professional, is he an expert of social media? No.
No.
Is he a graphic designer?
No. No.
Is he a guy who knows how to do coding? No.
No.
So we taught him the moves, asked him his expertise, and he learned the moves. He's watching, he's learning. He goes, I'm going to implement. He reaches out to thrive15.com and he basically enters into our coaching program. And I'm not exaggerating. This weekend, he spent $44. That was the confirmed number from Devin.
US dollars.
$44.
$44 US dollars.
And he generated 31 leads for his medical practice.
That's like a little over a dollar a lead.
That's crazy.
That is crazy.
And you know what? Facebook wasn't even a thing when he was going to medical school, let alone was it a viable thing for marketing. Oh, by the way, video, he didn't study that in school. Oh, by the way, he didn't study coding, but he realized, I know what I don't know.
And that's step one.
You got to recognize what you don't know and reach out to someone who knows what they're doing. And I'm telling you, ongoing education, there are many ways to have ongoing education. And I would like to bring up the three that I know about.
Oh, please do.
If you say, I don't want your Thrive15.com. I don't want it.
Keep it away from me.
But online education is a big thing.
Oh, yes, it is.
Two, workshops.
People love they like the touchy feely, raise their hand, get a question answered immediately, do the thing, the breakout. They love the breakout sessions.
Meeting people just like you.
Oh, that's one of the best.
When you realize I'm not crazy, there's other people who are
not crazy.
You can meet at workshops. And the third move is that one-on-one mentorship. Now we provide all three of those at thrive15.com, but I don't care how you get it, you've got to embrace this idea that education is a never-ending thing. Now here's another thing. Here's another stat that's gonna blow your mind. And we're going to talk about it a little more after the break here, Z. But 63% of wealthy, that would be you. If you're listening right now, this is you. 63% of wealthy are listening to educational audio during their commute to work, during their work day, versus 5% of the poor. That means you, by very virtue of being the elite members of the 1170...
The elite talk radio 1170.
Thrive Nation. You right now, literally, you are making a decision that puts you in the serious chances of success. 63% of wealthy people, Z, are listening to audio self-help.
So you're saying I've got a chance?
Yeah, you can absolutely do it. See, I'm not ripping on you. I'm just going to say, I don't have a degree. I don't have a pedigree. I don't have a rich uncle that helped me, fund my businesses. What I can say, though, is I learned these specific step-by-step systems that I'm going to teach you next, that we're going to teach you next. You want to stay tuned. We're going to teach you these specific moves after the break. All right, Thrive Nation, welcome back to the Thrive Time Show. This is not anymore during your drive time home. It's actually the Thrive Time Show during your lunch day. And you could be listening right now from Oklahoma Joe's, which you really should be. They're a great sponsor of the show. But the baked beans there, Z. If you're going, what am I going to eat today? I don't know. I'm hungry. You got to go get some Oklahoma Joe's. It's just game-changing barbecue. But if you're not having lunch right now, or maybe you're on your way to lunch, whatever you're doing, we're also on Facebook Live. You can go on Facebook Live. You can watch us right now. Or you can go to thrivetimeshow.com. And I'm telling you, we have thousands of people telling us they go to thrivetimeshow.com and they listen to the podcasts again. Maybe you missed a segment. You go to thrivetimeshow.com. You can listen to it, play it, play it back again, pause it, listen to it again, share it with a friend at ThriveTimeShow.com. My name is Clay Clark. I'm the SBA Entrepreneur of the Year. That's Dr. Robert Zellner. We're talking today about the American dream is possible. We're talking about the American dream is possible. If you aren't watching 5 hours of TV per day. And Z, a statistic that we were sharing before the break was that, check this out here, Thrivers, that the majority of wealthy people, 63% of wealthy people, report listening to audio, self-help audio books during their commute to work, during lunch, that kind of thing, versus 5% of poor people. See, why is it so important that you're always listening to positive self-help training, business type of things? You know, you're always kind of feeding your mind. Why is it so important?
Because I tell you what.
Wow.
What you put in is reflective on what comes out.
Oh.
And I've got good news.
This just in.
I've got good news. All of you out there listening to the Thrive Time Show today on Monday, and you might say to yourself, oh my gosh, who are these guys? What's going on?
Who are these people?
And you're listening to these practical business tips.
Tips.
And we're edifying and lifting you up and pumping you up so that you can be the best business version of yourself. And you're listening to us right now. Guess what?
What?
You're headed down the right road.
I am.
And it's true. Listen, I'll tell you what, folks. If you surround yourself and you input a lot of negativity into your brain, yeah, and you do have some control over what gets in and out of your brain, shocker, yeah, spoiler report there. If you keep putting positive things in, you can't help but having positive things come out. It's just the move.
It's just the move. Now, Z, I'm going to ask you this because somebody's listening right now, and they're not only listening to not positive, non-positive audio, but
no,
they
no.
are surrounded by
oh, no, don't
a
say it.
Virtual...
don't say it.
They're
say
surrounded
it.
By a cornucopia.
Oh,
if you will,
yeah.
A plethora uh-huh. of not positive people.
Idiots. Mean idiots.
They are surrounded by negative, mean idiots. Then maybe that's your roommate. And if you're listening with your roommate right now, just look ahead. Don't look at them. Don't make eye contact. It makes it awkward. Z, what advice would you have for someone right now? If you're listening right now, because there's a quote that Richard Branson talks about. Sir Richard Branson, the entrepreneur billionaire. He talks about how your network is your net worth. Talk to me about why you have to surround yourself with successful people, or at least people who want to become successful.
I tell you what, there's an old saying that they used to say that is so true, and that is, you run with the dogs, you're going to get fleas.
You run with the dogs and you're going to get what?
Fleas. What does that mean?
What does that mean?
Well, what that means is fleas, as is negative habits, negative things, will jump off of one person and onto the next person next to them. So if you surround yourself with people like that, i.e. you surround yourself with dogs, don't be surprised when you sit there and you're scratching going, I got fleas now.
I'm going to give you an example of this. Back in the day, some of the guys I hung out with, what we wanted to do is we wanted to know what the lyrics were to rap songs.
Oh, yeah.
We wanted to know what the lyrics were.
Well, why not?
So there's a song called Juicy by Notorious B.I.G. And he says, it was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine, Salt and Pepper and Heavy D up in the limousine. And we would go, what does that mean? We'd pause it. We'd listen to it again. We're like, Heavy D. Okay, Heavy D. We're trying to translate.
Gosh.
And then we're going, and then he would make a lyrics. He says, the landlord wondered why Christmas missed us. And we're like, oh, that's crazy.
That's the landlord.
And we're going, and then he goes, Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, when I was dead broke, man, I couldn't picture this. And I remember going, this is awesome.
It's inspiring.
And we would take hours reading the Source magazine and decoding the lyrics.
Oh, yeah.
And then we're like, oh, that, when he said bamboo, that doesn't mean what we thought it meant. Oh, no. And we used to spend our time doing this. That was the pursuit of knowledge. And
yes.
I'm telling you what, every one of the guys that I used to spend time doing this with, we were all unsuccessful and we all validated our unsuccess.
Yeah.
We'd all go, dude, I'm telling you, man, it's a system, man.
It's rigged.
Dude, out there.
You can't catch a break.
I remember one of my guys, I work in a call center, and my boss, a poor guy, this guy's name was Lex. And to give you a visual picture of Lex, he was like the office linebacker. He's an African-American guy, high enthusiasm, dressed sharp. And I remember he goes, Mr. Clark, if you do not follow this script, we do not have a place for you at this business. And
you're listening to the Thrive Time Show on Talk Radio 1170.
Whoa, wasn't ready for that one. And so he says, Mr. Clark, if you do not follow the system, we do not have a place for you here. And I turned to
the
guy next to
me. That's just mean.
See, I turned to the guy next to me, who, by the way, was one of my rap memorizing friends.
Oh, yeah.
And he goes, man, I tell you what, man, he's a sellout. You never want to end up like that. And I'm like, he goes, you got to keep it real. And I'm like, I do. And I remember, I stand up to Lex. I remember doing that. I was like, 18. I stand up to him and I'm like, you ain't going to talk to me like that. I remember saying those words. You ain't going to talk to me like that. And he goes, you're fired. And it was like, well, Whoa. See, that's what happens. And, rich people are always.
Yeah, it's the rigged system.
I'm just telling you right now, if you're listening right now, you've got to surround yourself with successful people. Now, another statistic.
Okay. So I've got negative Nancy next door in the cubicle next door.
Yeah, negative Nancy.
If you're in your cubicle and you have a negative Nancy next door, don't look right now because you're listening to the show. You got your earbuds in. Maybe you're listening, or maybe you're playing it out loud. And people in the next cubicles are waiting to see if you look over at them.
Success is just not possible. It's just not possible.
Okay, we talk about the show being practical tips. We talk about giving action steps. We talk about these things.
Yep.
All right. So you're in your cubicle and you got negative Nancy barking in your ear. The whole time you're at work, just negative, negative, negative. What do you do about that?
I'll tell you what I would do. First thing that I would do is I'd lead by example that I am not going to let somebody else impact my day.
Okay, and so what does that look like? What does that look like?
Once I got positive, there was a guy who worked next to me at Faith Highway. I worked at a business called Faith Highway.
Okay.
We sold evangelism commercials to churches, most notably to Joel Osteen's church.
Okay,
it's kind of a big deal. The guy next to me used to go, Bro, do you want to go to the bathroom, bro? And I go in and he goes, bro, no, seriously, when you have coffee break and boss doesn't even know, bro. Like, we could go get coffee. Now, by the way, the job was like 80% commission. He goes, bro, we could leave and Jeremy won't even know we're gone. And I remember I looked at him. And I'm not kidding. And I go, what? He goes, dude, he doesn't even check, bro. We could be gone and we're still collecting hourly. And dude, by the way, if you don't clock out, no one knows. It's an extra $6.50 a week, bro. I did the math. It's like $30 a week. And I remember that. And I'm going, I looked at the guy, and I won't mention his name, but I looked at him and I said, I really want you to understand that everything you're saying to me, I'm blocking it out like earmuffs. I'm done with it, man.
Wow. Oh, you stood up to.
I did. And I focused on the prize. And what I did is I decided, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna work straight through lunch. I'm not gonna go on a lunch. I'm just gonna work straight through lunch. And I'm gonna look around the office and find find the most successful person.
Yes.
And there was a guy in the office named Ron Hood. And you've met Mr. Ron.
Oh yeah, great guy.
And Ron, if you meet Ron, Ron is just a driver. He's just let me go get it. I get to work, every day I get to work, like 8:30. He's already been there.
Yeah.
So I said, Ron, who are you calling? He goes, listen, I remember he goes, you have such stinking thinking, you can't even see things that are just, he was like so frustrated, he couldn't even articulate how mad he was.
I've been there.
And he goes, listen, we have people who live on the East Coast, churches that have a church on the East Coast, it is not 8 now. And I'm not exaggerating, I go, what time is it? He goes, dude, it's an hour after now. It is 9:30. So I can start calling them at 8 o'clock because it's 9 there. And by the way, successful people get to work early. So I start calling them at 7, but no one else is here. So it's quiet. So people like you quit asking me questions. And I go, so Ron, what are your tips to success? And he goes, make 200 calls a day and you'll be successful.
That's a lot of calls.
And I'm thinking like, is that even possible?
Yeah.
Because I was making like the minimum quota of like 75 a day. And he goes, yeah, what you do is, and by the way, the movie The Pursuit of Happiness by Will Smith, you need to watch this. And Will Smith plays the part of the character who went from being a homeless man to a multi-million dollar stockbroker. But the thing about it is you can literally make 200 calls a day in a call center if you have a system. Mm-hmm. And I started asking him how to do it. And I'm telling you what, he taught me how to leave a voicemail that gets a call back. He taught me how to make 200 calls. He taught me how you call all your leads first. You call all your leads first thing in the morning. And then at noon, you flip over the lead list and you call them again, but in reverse order. So that way you keep reaching people at different times and you'll get a hold of them.
Yeah.
He taught me about taking notes and finding their hot button and building rapport. And I took the time that I previously was, I'm not even kidding, I was spending time with a man trying to pretend like we were having coffee or going to the bathroom or whatever. My goal was to trick my boss into paying me while I wasn't actually working. And I transformed by just studying successful people, Izzy, and blocking out the negative people.
And that's what you do. And you know what? What I love about that story, it was your choice. It was your choice. It was your choice. You can either be led down the path of sneaking around and beating the boss out of money and really robbing the company. Ooh, that's a little tough. Sorry. It's a little hard.
When you say the word rob, it sounds like you're judging.
Rob. Well, it's part of my first name, so I'm able to say it. Rob Ert is my name. But or you made the conscious effort to say, you know what? I'm at the fork in the road. I can go this way or this way. And you went the way of success. And that's what. Listen, for anybody out there, and you're at that fork in the road right now, and you've got a negative Nancy in your ear, and for all the Nancys out there, I'm sorry, I just kind of use that term.
So is it
twice? I couldn't help it. My mom gave it to me. Listen, you can make the choice today. You can make the choice today to block that out, find the successful one, and let them mentor you up. And you know what? Let us help you. We're going to coach you up a little bit too.
Now, see, when we come back, there is a statistic that will blow your mind. We're trying to help you vaccinate you against poverty-causing habits. Stay tuned. All right, Thrive Nation, welcome back to your inspiration station. This is Business School Without the BS. And yes, my name is Clay Clark. I'm the former SBA Entrepreneur of the Year in your ear. And I'm joined, as always, with a guy. He's an entrepreneur. He really is at his heart, at his core. He is an entrepreneur, but he is trapped inside an optometrist's body. Dr. Zellner, I'm going to let you explain to the Thrive Nation what that means when you are trapped inside an optometrist's body.
I had a guy the other day said, you own an auto auction. I said, yes, sir. I bought the land, built the buildings, and went out and gathered some business, hired the right guys, and I had the successful, thriving auto auction business called Z66 Auto Auction.
Quick interruption I have to people. Okay. You're selling on, 700, 800, 1,000 cars, whatever. You're selling over 700 cars in like 4 or 5 hours?
More like 2 or 3 hours.
So in 2 or 3 hours, you're selling 700 cars. Somebody listening right now, do the math and figure out how many cars you're selling per minute. And while you're doing the math, Z, go ahead and continue. I just want to blow their minds with the profundity of that thought.
Okay. And then the same person said, and you own this diagnostic sleep center. And I said, yeah, it's Dr. Z's, get it? Z's Sleep Center.
I do get it.
And they kind of scratched their and looked at me and they said, but I thought you were an eye doctor.
I thought you were an eye doctor.
I thought you were an optometrist.
Don't you care about the pupil?
And I said, yeah, I'm an optometrist, but why does that have to limit me from being an entrepreneur? You know, that's the thing about it is everybody wants to paint you. Everybody wants to put you in a shell, paint you in a corner, judge you by your cover. Everybody wants to put you over here and say, well, this is your ceiling. This is your limit. This is all you can do.
I have something I would like to say. I'd like to get it out here in the open. I would never go to an optometrist who is also a car doctor, because you're either going to be a doctor of the cars or a doctor of the eyeballs. And when you're out there talking about your sleep center, it freaks me out. I mean, what are you? You got to choose. You got to be a focus area.
Listen.
You got to focus on one thing. Because when I grew up, all I did was focus, Dr. Z. Focus. What is wrong with you? Why can't you just be a better focused person?
Well, here's the thing. When you drive up to my optometry clinic, Dr. Robert Zellner and Associates, and you park your car, we don't run out there, take the keys from you, and auction it off.
What?
And when you come into the auto auction, you're a used car dealer and you're looking for some cars to sell on your lot. You don't come in there and I don't put you in a chair, a hydraulic chair, and ask you which is better, one or two. So the businesses are separate and do separate things. But the idea, listen out there, that no matter what your education is, i.e. Clay Clark, you got thrown out of college, okay, he's a little strong, asked not to come back. Let's just put it that way.
I feel like you always attack that man. All he wants to do is help you out. And it's like,
I'm just telling him, listen,
stating facts.
Even if you don't have a college degree, i.e. Clay Clark, who's probably the world's best business coach, by the way, even if you don't have that, whatever category you're in, whatever you've done or not done, listen, it's not your limiting membrane. You can do whatever it is you want to do. This country is great. And if you're listening around the world, there's great opportunities in every country to be an entrepreneur and to do what you want to do. And don't let people tell you what you can and can't do, Clay.
No,
that's the thing about it. You ask about that, but it's like, people look at you and they scratch their head and they go, how are you doing that?
I'm going to make a list right now of people that I know of off the top of my head. I read these books all the time, so I'm going to make it fairly, I'll go fast.
All right.
But it's something you need to hear, Thrivers. Henry Ford, take a guess. How many times did Henry Ford lose everything? One time?
What?
Two times? Five times.
Five times.
Do you know what that would have felt like, by the way? Henry Ford, this is pre-online banking, pre-group funding, pre-crowdfunding. This is a guy who went to everyone he knew and said, would you be willing to invest in my Ford Motor Company? And they say yes. And he loses it all. Z, five times. Could you imagine what it would be like to have invested in a guy who lost your money twice?
You're listening to the Thrive Time Show on Talk Radio 1170.
I mean, how do you even recover from that? It's like, well, guys, I know the first three times I lost it, but this fourth time, I'm telling you, this is going to be a winner. Like, dude, you lost my money three times. Well, I'm telling you, I'm making a comeback. You know, and then Walt Disney, he lost it how many times? Thrivers, take a guess. Two.
Two. I thought it was three.
Two. He lost it twice. Could you imagine what it would be like losing it twice?
Oh, yep. I could just see it over Thanksgiving dinner. They're carving the turkey, and he stands up. Ah, I just, I want to, I'm sorry about those other two ventures.
Those other two ventures.
Those other two things. But you see, there was a thing about a thing. So I, you know, so I tell you what, if we dig right now, get out your checkbooks. Let's you know, have faith in me. I know I've lost your nest egg twice now, but have faith in me. And we're gonna do this thing. I'm gonna make a theme park. What's that mean? I don't know either. But we're going to make a theme park, and we're going to entertain people, and I'm going to have a big mouse that's going to be kind of the key guy, okay?
Totally rational.
Well, he's not a rat. He's a mouse. Uncle Billy's a... No. Uncle Billy. No, he's a mouse, not a rat, okay?
I mean... Thomas Edison, imagine working for a guy who spent 10,000 logged failed experiments making something that didn't work. He's trying to make the light bulb. Could you imagine for 7 years going to work for a man who just continues raising capital and he's never made even one working prototype? This is a true story. He finally loses his mind. Sam, you need to hear this. This is good for your soul. He loses his mind and he's like, we got to find something that some kind of conductor, some sort of thing. I know it's going to work. Just get me something. And a guy in his office, true story, if you read his book, true story. The guy goes like, and he rips off a piece of cardboard. He gives it to him. He puts it in and the light happens. And he's like, There it is. I mean, could you imagine? I mean, Thrivers.
7 years, 10,000.
10,000. I mean, that's, but then he goes on to invent recorded video and audio. How weird would it be to go to a movie today if you didn't have video or audio or light? What would you be doing? You're sitting in a dark room? I mean, so I'm just
imagining.
He changed the game. So if you're listening right now, you are qualified to be successful. You can absolutely do it. Now, listen to this, Thrivers. Listen to this, okay? 84% of wealthy people believe that good habits create luck versus 4% of the poor. Where does this come from? Tom Corley, his well-researched book, Habits of the Rich. Z, why is that so profound to embrace the concept that your habits actually dictate your success and not just luck?
Well, I think, I won the lottery. You see, I went and bought a ticket and for $2, and they called my numbers, and therefore I won.
Can't win if you don't buy.
Yeah, you can't win if you don't buy. Well, that right there goes to my old saying I used to say, and that is, the harder I work, the luckier I get.
Oh, boom.
Everybody's out there sitting around waiting for someone to give them something. And now, not you that are listening to the show, because you guys are motivated, you're determined, and you're thrivers. And we're going to coach you up, and we're going to give some practical tips on how to do that. And one of the first steps is doing this, is understanding that your daily routine, the stuff that you do every single day and the order you do it in, matters.
What?
It matters.
What?
I love what you said about Ron Hood coaching you up on the call center.
Oh, yeah.
Those are great practical tips of, you know, calling everybody in the reverse order, trying to catch them at different times, leaving them a message that they can't stand, they got to call you back.
At our workshops, we teach people specifically how to set up a call center.
Oh, so cool.
We have an entire multi-hour, we train you how to set up a successful call center. And by the way, it works.
Yeah,
we've taught it to Hewlett Packard.
Yep.
We taught it to Oral Roberts University, other companies, and it works. Now, Thrivers, I want you to listen to this. We're talking about habits. When we come back, we're gonna deep dive into this concept of how to make a daily to-do list, because this right here is that little thing that so many entrepreneurs forget time and time again. But I'm gonna tell you this. The majority, 81% of wealthy people maintain a to-do list versus just 19%. 15% of the poor. You want to know more about how Dr. Z makes his to-do list? You want to know how he made his to-do list when he was just getting started? You want to know how to make a daily to-do list that you can turn into a to-done list? Stay tuned. Thrive Time Show. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. You're listening to Michael Jack, and we are back on the Thrive Time Show, broadcasting from the Man Cave. And Thrivers, let me tell you what. If you're listening right now and you're going, is this politics? Is this? I don't hear any politics.
Is this home and gardening?
There's no Bernie Sanders references. There's no Hillary Clinton references.
Never mentioned Obama once.
There's no immigration references. This appears to be a business show. A show about business?
Ding, 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 ding.
It's not as boring as I knew. What is this? It's the Thrive Time Show, and we are so excited to be here with you. My name's Clay Clark. I'm the SBA Entrepreneur of the Year for the state of Oklahoma back in the day, and I'm joined here with a man, a mentor, an entrepreneur, a guy who it excites me to be in his physical presence because he has done it the right way for a long time. Is he perfect? No. But I'd say what, you just celebrated 25 years of success with Dr. Robert Zeller and Associates. And I'm going to tell you what, the economy was up, the economy was down, the interest rates went up, they went down, different presidents, but you have continued to pound out a year-over-year profit. And it's, sir, it is an honor to be here with you, Dr. Z. I love having you on the show. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great. I thought there was a different reason you were kind of excited and kind of edgy when you're around me.
Fear?
Well, you know I pack a taser.
Oh yeah,
and I will hit you with that. I will
tell you what. Once you get the first taser, the second taser is always the worst one. The first one, it's kind of like,
it's like the second
one's always a little bit.
It's
worse.
Always a little bit.
The
worse.
The third though, you're numb at this point.
You're numb. You don't really care.
Yeah.
So listen, thanks for tuning in, folks. We went to a new time. Well, here we are.
New
12
time.
12 to 2, Monday through Friday. So now instead of drive time or dinner time, we're kind of like at lunchtime.
And there's kind of a more energy I've noticed, because I always wake up like at 4 in the morning and try to go to bed like at something crazy like 10
like
4 p.m.
in the morning. Like 4 in the morning.
You're more of a night owl. I'm more of a morning guy.
This morning
is the perfect blend. This is the perfect blend.
Because we're both probably in the
peak energy.
The thing.
Now, Z, before we went to the break, we were talking about how 67% of wealthy people write down their goals versus 17%, according to Tom Corley in his investigative book on the habits of the rich. Z, why is it so important to write down your goals, and how did you do it when you were first building your first business?
You know, 25 years ago, we didn't have all the computer stuff. Now, you know, now I see your to-do list is always, you know, printed out and nice and neat, and
9-point font.
9.9 point font. What is that? 9-point font? Why not 8.83 font? Anyway, but back in the day, we'd write it down, and it was. I tell you what, if you've never made a to-do list, it is so fun to scratch, to write through, to mark one of those suckers off.
Oh yeah,
it is just feel like I did it. I did it. And when you're starting a business, I tell you what, you may say to yourself, okay, what do I need to do? Boom, boom, boom. We're going to tell you. We're going to walk you through it. We're going to coach you. But you know what? When we do that, get your to-do list and write the stuff down and put it. And here's the other thing too that I love to do. I used to always write it from what was the most important, the most urgent,
oof,
to the least urgent. And then I would work down my list. I guess if you wanted, you could work up it.
By the way, Z, your system you're teaching right now, what you did, whether you recognize it or not, is the exact system that Lee Cockrell, who, oh, by the way, used to manage 40,000 people as the former executive vice president of Disney World. We're talking about 1 million tourists a week.
Oh, yeah.
And he said he stayed at your house.
Oh yeah, great
he stayed
guy.
With you, and he says
he was the real deal.
You put the
or
top,
is the real deal.
You put the top priorities first.
Yes,
on that list.
Yes,
you do that.
You do that, and then guess what? Anything throughout the day that takes away from that, that discourages that you know slows that down, you remove it. You remove it. You fight through it. All the idiots, all the stuff, all the rabbit trails, all the junk.
I have a story.
All the endless emails that mean nothing.
You're a nice guy, but I'm going to tell you a story about Steve Jobs.
Okay.
In his book by Walter Isaacson, he explains this rule a little bit. In his autobiography, by the way, his book, it starts off great, but he explains, like, basically, as I tell you this, the things that I'm telling you that are bad about me are true. The things I'm telling you good about me are true, but the book is true. It's basically kind of this idea.
Sure.
Well, one of the things he did is he has this rule of six,
okay,
where he would only acknowledge the physical presence of six people in the building at any time. I'm not kidding.
Okay,
so what he would do is he's like, you know, you're the COO, you're the CEO, you're the chief marketing guy, you're the chief, and as a way for me to honor the hierarchy and to maintain focus, I am 100% accessible by you. If you six call me, I'm available. You call me anytime, night or day, I'm available.
Yes.
Anybody else, I don't even know who they are. I refuse to acknowledge them. Now you have to know about your six. So you, the COO, need to know about the six of your people.
Sure.
And then he needs to know about his six people.
Oh, that's management just gold right there.
And he would do, and people would talk about how they go, he would walk by them in the office and they'd say, "What's up, Steve?" And he would never respond or even look them in the eye. And only after he came back from cancer, like his second time, did he start to go, maybe that's a pretty intense move. But you know what? You can't argue with the guy. Literally, totally transformed animation.
Yes.
He was the CEO of Pixar.
Pixar.
People don't know that. He launched the Toy Story movie. He took over Pixar for George Lucas. True story. Yeah. He launched the first personal computer you could use.
Yeah.
He launched the iPhone. He launched the iPad. He launched the iTunes. I mean, the iTunes. I mean, and how do you do it? Homie was focused.
He was laser focused.
And I'm going to get, if you're listening right now and you want to know what does focus mean? Focus means this: focus on core tasks until success. I repeat, focus. Someone needs to write that down. Focus on core tasks. The T didn't fit, but until success.
Yes.
And I'll tell you this, if you harness the sun's rays on a given point, we using a magnifying glass and you hold it there,
yep.
You can set some leaves on fire.
Well, you'd never want to burn an ant. That's just mean. That's cruel.
Yeah, I wouldn't. I mean, you could burn like a piece of concrete.
No, a slug. You wouldn't do that.
You would burn a leaf, but it would be thoroughly dead.
You wouldn't want to start a fire.
Now, here's the deal, Thrivers. When we come back, we're going to teach you the final move that if you can fight through this wealth-destroying habit, if you can fight through this move, we guarantee that you will be successful. You want to know what that move is? You got to stay tuned here. It is the Thrive Time Show. Now, during our new time. Thrive Time Show. All right, Thrive Nation, welcome back to your inspiration station, your audio dojo of mojo. It's kind of like, if you're in your car right now, it's kind of like your mobile library. If you're at your office, it's that audio self-help channel with a little bit of fun sprinkled in there. It is the Thrive Time Show. My name is Clay Clark. I'm the former SBA Entrepreneur of the Year. And here we have Dr. Robert Zellner. We're talking today about how the American dream is absolutely possible if you do these things. The American dream is absolutely possible if you do these things. Now, the thing that I would like to leave you with, and Z and I were talking about this a little bit after the air, a little bit off the air, is that you absolutely have to have a crystal clear, white hot a vision or a dream. And I'll say this before I turn it over to you, Z. It is so dangerous that you get into this habit of just sleepwalking through life. As an example, you go to work, you go to church, you go home. Pretty soon it starts to kind of, I go to work, I go to church, I go to home. Pretty soon it starts to kind of get in a rhythm. I go to work, I go to church, I go to home. Now I'm 40. I go to work, I go to church, I go to home. Now I'm 50. Oh no, I'm going to work. I go to, oh wait a second. All of a sudden you're like, whoa, 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 what just happened? And we want to wake you up today. We want you to dream. We want to wake you up, Z. I'm going to wake you up.
I'm going to challenge everybody out there listening, okay? You say, what is this show? As I'm eating my lasagna at lunch in the break room, and I'm listening to this audio excellence that's coaching me up on me getting my dream. I'm telling you what, here's the challenge. Here's the Thrive Time Challenge for anybody listening out there, okay? And thank you for listening, by the way, Thrivers. Thank you. We're going to call you Thrivers if you listen to this show, or if you get on our website, thrive15.com.
Yeah.
Become a member of Business School Excellence. But I'm going to give you here's the challenge. Here's the challenge.
Here it is.
And I hope you're up to it. Tonight, today, you've got the rest of the afternoon, this evening, you've got dinner time.
Give me a second. I got to get a pen. I want to write this down.
Okay.
Here we go. I'm getting a pen. Yep. Let me get my pen. Okay.
Here's your challenge.
Let me get my
Here's your challenge. I'm going to challenge you. Forbes says that 57% of you listening out there want to start a business. And I believe them because I see it in people's eyes. People come up to me all the time and say, how did you do it? What's the secret?
Give me a secret sauce.
And that's what we're doing in this show. Hang in there. Listen to us every day, 12 to 2, and you're going to get that secret sauce. But here's your challenge, the Thrive Time Challenge from Dr. Z. I want you to get a pen or pencil. Yes, that's an actual pen or pencil. And a piece of paper. Yes, that's an actual piece of paper. One that crinkles and makes this noise. Like that. And I want you to write down your dream. You see, that's the thing about it is that people are like, the American dream's alive. And they go, wow, that's awesome. The American dream is alive. And they look in the mirror and they go, what is that? What is that? Here's the. It's that little thing, that little burning ember that people have thrown water on, that people have tried to stamp on.
See, I don't ever think that your dream's going to come true. It's never going to happen.
That your Aunt Connie sat there and told you that you're never going to do it. It can't be done. What are you thinking? You're crazy. That little ember that's still down in there, we're fanning it right now. We're going to get it up and get it kind of going again. But here's the deal. Write it down. And I know you may say, why would I do that?
I don't believe in paper.
I don't believe
I am overall more of an inch of sketch and an
Can
iPad.
Can I text it to somebody?
Can I text it? Do I have to write it down on paper?
That's not a bad idea. Text it to someone and say, you know, I took this Thrive Time challenge and I've got to come up, I've got to write down my dream. And the dream is the business I want to start, the thing I want to do, the widget I want to make, the problem I want to solve. Because that's what it's about. That's what business is about, is finding a problem and solving it profitably. What, profit? Yes, you're making money doing it, and then that leads to your American dream of time freedom, financial freedom, being able to take care of your family, leaving an inheritance to your children's children.
I have something offensive, Z. I'm sorry to interrupt. I have something offensive I want to share.
Are we going to fight? Are we fighting?
No, this is just, it's. I think if you're listening to it, it sounds so mean, and so it's easier if I just quote somebody.
Oh, okay. So it's not coming from you.
Benjamin Franklin, right?
He's
one of our founding fathers of the United States of America. He is the father of the mullet.
Yes.
He's a successful author, printer, politician, postmaster, diplomat. By the way, he created the Franklin stove.
He did the bifocals.
Bifocals. He did the bifocals, which is great. It allows me to see. He says this, we are born ignorant. I repeat, this is Benjamin Franklin, not me.
Okay.
We are all born ignorant, but one must work hard to remain stupid. Oh, see, he had to say that. You have to work hard to remain stupid.
Yeah, I just put it all behind. I think it's really a skullet. Look, it's really more of a skullet, isn't it?
It is kind of a skullet. Look at that. You're on Facebook Live right now. Look at that.
Bald on top, and he's got business up front. I mean, that's business. That's business time right there.
Business time right there.
You know what that is in the back right there?
That's a total party.
That's total party time.
Now, here's the deal. If you're listening right now, I'm just saying, though, if you haven't been dreaming actively, if you've just sort of accepted that you have this station in life, this certain situation where you're stuck in and you're going, I'm 40, I can't do it. Look up Colonel Sanders tonight. How old was he when he made success? Ray Kroc. You know Ray Kroc, the guy who went on to buy the Padres and, oh, by the way, grew McDonald's and franchised it?
Kind of a Big Mac kind of thing.
Didn't have any discernible success until he was like early 50s. So I'm telling you, if you're listening right now, it's never too late. See, what encouragement would you have for the person listening right now who goes, it's probably too late for me. It's probably, you know, like Darth Vader. He's like, it's too late for me, Luke. It's too late. What advice would you have?
I mean, Warren Buffett made most of his money after the age of 60. It is what it is, folks. I mean, you can't change how old you are, but you can change what you're doing tomorrow, okay? And this show, we're going to give you practical tips. And the first step in owning your piece of the American dream, the first step is acknowledging what your dream is. And you may say to yourself, I've been told so many times, it's crazy. I've been told so many times it can't be done. I've been told so many times that business is stupid, you know? But I'm telling you right now, step one, taking the Thrive Challenge, is for you tonight, today, to write down that dream, that entrepreneurial dream, okay? Because I know there's a lot of you out there listening that say, you know what? I'm tired of punching the clock. I'm tired of this 9-to-5 job. I want independence. I want to do my own thing. And folks, we're going to help coach you up for that. That's what we do. That's our passion. That is our passion. I'm telling you right now, the man just to my left right now, the co-host of this show, is probably one of the best business coaches around. I'm here just to kind of lighten the mood and kind of bring a little color commentary every now and then. I mean, I've done it. You know, and I've mentored people before,
right?
But this guy's written books. He's smart. He knows what he's doing. And I'm telling you, if you tune in every day from 12 to 2, yeah, you're eating your lunch, your little tuna salad, your whatever your move is, peanut butter and jelly, which is a fine meal, by the way.
It's a fine meal.
It's a fine meal. If whatever you're eating over lunch, and when you're sitting at your desk, maybe you're driving somewhere, maybe you sneak out because you're like, I don't want anybody to know I'm thinking about starting my own business. But anyway, put your earbuds in, listen to us. But I'm telling you what, step one is writing down what that dream is, what your dream business is, what your dream deal is, and your dream product, your dream problem you want to solve. Let's just start with that, and then let's go from there, okay?
And Thrivers, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, once you have determined this dream, we're only asking you to do one thing today. Determine that dream, write it down, get a crystal clear focus. And now after you have that dream, after you have that totally taken from, by the way, thoughts can become things when you write them down. Thoughts can become things when you write them down. But after you've written this down, you've done that tonight, now you get into this deal where you have to ask yourself, does the Thomas Edison quote that Clay's about ready to say, the Thomas Edison quote, I'm about ready to say, does this apply to me? Thomas Edison says that vision without execution is hallucination. Vision without execution is hallucination. So once you have the dream, if you don't do anything with it, you're not going to have any success. So on tomorrow's show, we're going to be talking to you specifically about how to take that dream and how to turn it into action steps. See, how to actually execute the big dream and turn it into action items. That's why I'm so excited about tomorrow's show.
I'm excited too, but listen, let's say, you know what? That's 24 hours away. I can't wait that long.
I can't wait that long.
I want to do something now. You've got me excited. You got me pumped up. I'm fired up. I wrote down my dream while I was listening to Z tell me to write down my dream today. I've already got it down. I've got it written down.
What can I do right now?
What can I do today? Because you know what? 24 hours, that's like twice as much as 12 hours.
You've got three moves you can do. Three moves.
Well, okay then.
Here we go. You got three moves. Move number one, you can go to thrive15.com. Okay. And I want to tell you something about our scholarship program we have. You go to thrive15.com. It is the world's best business school. Dr. Z and I have invested millions, I literally repeat to you, millions of dollars into building the world's best business school. You go up there, check it out. And by the way, there's a scholarship program. So if you can't afford it, you can actually just set your own sort of price right there. And set your own price? Yeah, we care that much. And if you're military, it's free.
Free.
So, thrive15.com, world's best business school. $20 a month, but if you can't afford it, just go choose your price. Second thing, Z.
It's actually $19 a month. I don't want to call you a liar for a dollar.
$19 a month. Yeah, $19 a month. That's just it.
I mean, I don't want
to. Poor marketing move here. Poor marketing move.
19 gathers more than 20. It's unbelievable. The price point theorem of marketing.
Now, move number two you can do. You could attend a thrive15.com workshop.
You mean in person where I could actually meet you and touch you? Can I touch
today,
you?
Days at a almost 20,000 square foot facility called the Thrive 15 World Headquarters. If you go on YouTube and Google search on YouTube for the Thrive 15 World Headquarters, you'll see it. We're in Jinx, America, on the left coast of the Arkansas River. You can attend that thing. And if you want to learn more about it, go to thrivetimeshow.com. Or move number three, you could reach out to us and schedule a personal analysis with an actual business coach who will coach you through the step-by-step mentorship program. See, it's all available. We have it for any price point. And if you're military, by the way, the online school, thrive15.com, is always free. Thank you for serving. See if I forgot something.
Well, yes, you forgot that there's scholarships for the in-person workshops also.
If you can't afford it.
I tell you what, we want you to succeed that much. We're here for you. Email us at info@thrive15.com and we're ready to answer your questions.
And as always, Z, 3, 2, 1. Whoa.
JT, do you know what time it is?
4:10.
It's Tebow time in Tulsa, Jerusalem, baby. Tim Tebow is coming to Tulsa, Oklahoma, June 27th and 28th. We've been doing business conferences here since 2005. I've been hosting business conferences since 2005. What year were you born?
1995.
Dude, I've been hosting business conferences since you were 10 years old, but I've never had the two-time Heisman Award-winning Tim Tebow come present. And a lot of people, you know, have followed Tim Tebow's football career on the field and off the field. And off the field, the guy's been just as successful as he has been on the field. Now, the big question is, JT, how does he do it?
Well, they're going to have to come and find out because I don't know.
Well, I'm just saying, Tim Tebow's going to teach us how he organizes his day, how he organizes his life, how he's proactive with his faith, his family, his finances. He's going to walk us through his mindset that he brings into the gym, into business. It is going to be a blasty blast in Tulsa, Jerusalem. Also, this is the first Thrive Time Show event that we've had where we're going to have a man who has built a $100 million net worth.
Wow.
Who'll be presenting. Now, we've had a couple presenters that have had a $1 billion net worth in some like real estate sort of things.
Yeah.
But this is the first time we've had a guy who's built a service business and he's built over $100 million net worth in the service business. It's the yacht driving, multi-state living guru of franchising. Peter Taunton will be in the house. This is the founder of Snap Fitness, the guy behind 9-Round Boxing. He's going to be here in Tulsa, Jerusalem, Oklahoma, June 27th and 28th. JT, why should everybody want to hear what Peter Taunton has to say?
Oh, because he's incredible. He's just a fountain of knowledge. He is awesome. He has inspired me listening to him talk. And not only that, he also has He practices what he teaches, so he's a real teacher. He's not a fake teacher like business school teachers, so you got to come learn from him.
Also, let me tell you this, folks. I don't want to get this wrong, because if I get it wrong, someone's going to say, you screwed that up, buddy. So Michael Levine, this is Michael Levine. He's going to be coming. You say, who's Michael Levine? I don't want to get this wrong. This is the PR consultant of choice for Michael Jackson, for Prince, for Nike, for Charlton Heston, for Nancy Kerrigan, 34 Grammy Award winners, 43 New York Times bestselling authors he's represented, including pretty much everybody you know who's been a super celebrity. This is Michael Levine, a good friend of mine. He's going to come and talk to you about personal branding and the mindset needed to be super successful. The lineup will continue to grow. We have hit Christian recording artist Colton Dixon in the house. Now, people say, Colton Dixon's in the house? Yes, Colton Dixon's in the house. So if you like top 40 Christian music, Colton Dixon's going to be in the house performing. The lineup will continue to grow each and every day. We're going to add more and more speakers to this all-star lineup. But I encourage everybody out there today, get those tickets today. Go to ThriveTimeShow.com. Again, that's ThriveTimeShow.com. And some people might be saying, well, how do I do it? What do I do? How does it work? You just go to ThriveTimeShow.com. Let's go there now. We're feeling the flow. We're going to ThriveTimeShow.com. Again, you just go to ThriveTimeShow.com. You click on the business conferences button, and you click on the request tickets button right there. The way I do our conferences is we tell people it's $250 to get a ticket.
Yep.
Or whatever price that you can afford. And the reason why I do that is I grew up without money. JT, you're in the process of building a super successful company. Did you start out with $1 million in the bank account?
No, I did not. Nope. Did not get any loans, nothing like that. Did not get an inheritance from parents or anything like that. I had to work for it. And I'm super grateful I came to a business conference. That's actually how I met you, met Peter Taunton. I met all these people.
So if you're out there today and you want to come to our workshop, again, you just got to go to ThriveTimeShow.com. You might say, well, when's it going to be? June 27th and 28th. You might say, well, who's speaking? We already covered that. You might say, where's it going to be? It's going to be in Tulsa, Rusalem, Oklahoma. And someone says, Tulsa, Rusalem. I'm really trying to rebrand Tulsa as Tulsa, Rusalem, sort of like the Jerusalem of America. But if you type in Thrive Time Show and Jinx, you can get a sneak peek or a look at our office facility. This is what it looks like. This is where you're headed. It's going to be a blasty blast. You can look inside, see the facility. We're going to have hundreds of entrepreneurs here. It is going to be packed. Now, for this particular event, folks, the seating is always limited because my facility isn't a limitless convention center. You're coming to my actual home office, and so it's going to be packed. So when June 27th and 28th, you're going to come. I'm talking to you. You can just get your tickets right now at ThriveTimeShow.com. And again, you can name your price. We tell people it's $250 or whatever price you can afford. And we do have some select VIP tickets, which gives you an access to meet some of the speakers and those sorts of things. And those tickets are $500. It's a two-day interactive business workshop, over 20 hours of business training. We're going to give you a copy of my newest book, The Millionaire's Guide to Becoming Sustainably Rich. You're going to leave with a workbook. You're going to leave with everything you need to know to start and grow a super successful company. It's practical, it's actionable, and it's Tebow time right here in Tulsa, Jerusalem. Get those tickets today at ThriveTimeShow.com. Again, that's ThriveTimeShow.com.
Hello, I'm Michael Levine, and I'm talking to you right now from the center of Hollywood, California, where I have represented, over the last 35 years, 58 Academy Award winners, 34 Grammy Award winners, 43 New York Times bestsellers. I've represented a lot of major stars, and I've worked with a lot of major companies. And I think I've learned a few things about what makes them work and what makes them not work. Now, why would a man living in Hollywood, California, in the beautiful sunny weather of LA, come to Tulsa? Because last year I did it, and it was damn exciting. Clay Clark has put together an exceptional presentation, really life-changing, and I'm looking forward to seeing you then. I'm Michael Levine. I'll see you in Tulsa.
James, did I tell you my good friend John Lee Dumas is also joining us at the in-person, two-day interactive Thrive Time Show business workshop? That Tim Tebow and that Michael Levine will be at. Have I told you this?
You have not told me that.
Oh, he's coming all the way from Puerto Rico. This is John Lee Dumas, the host of the chart-topping EOFire.com podcast. He's absolutely a living legend. This guy started a podcast after wrapping up his service in the United States military. And he started recording this podcast daily in his home to the point where he started interviewing big time folks like Gary Vaynerchuk, like Tony Robbins, and he just kept interviewing bigger and bigger names, putting out shows day after day. And now he is the legendary host of the EO Fire podcast, and he's traveling all the way from Puerto Rico to Tulsa, Oklahoma to attend the in-person June 27th and 28th Thrive Time Show, two-day interactive business workshop. If you're out there today, folks, you've ever wanted to grow a podcast, a broadcast, you want to improve your marketing, if you've ever wanted to improve your marketing, your branding, if you've ever wanted to increase your sales, you want to come to the two-day interactive June 27th and 28th Thrive Time Show business workshop featuring Tim Tebow, Michael Levine, John Lee Dumas, and countless big-time, super successful entrepreneurs. It's going to be life-changing. Get your tickets right now at ThriveTimeShow.com. James, what website is that?
ThriveTimeShow.com.
James, one more time before enthusiasm.
ThriveTimeShow.com.
Shining, everything rides on tonight. Even if I got three strikes, I'ma go for it. This moment, we own it. I'm not to be played with, because it could get dangerous. See these people I ride with. This moment, we own it.
Thrive Time Show two-day interactive business workshops are the world's highest rated and most reviewed business workshops, because we teach you what you need to know to grow.
You can learn the proven 13-point business system that Dr. Zellner and I have used over and over to start and grow successful companies. I mean, we get into the specific steps on what you need to do to optimize your website. We're going to teach you how to fix your conversion rate. We're going to teach you how to do a social media marketing campaign that works. How do you raise capital? How do you get a small business loan? We teach you everything you need to know here during a two-day, 15-hour workshop. It's all here for you. You work every day in your business, but for 2 days you can escape and work on your business and build these proven systems, so now you can have a successful company that will produce both the time freedom and the financial freedom that you deserve. You're going to leave energized, motivated, but you're also going to leave empowered. The reason why I've built these workshops is because as an entrepreneur, I always wish that I had this. And because there wasn't anything like this, I would go to these motivational seminars, no money down, real estate, Ponzi scheme, get motivated seminars, and they would never teach me anything. It was like you went there and you paid for the big chocolate Easter bunny, but inside of it, it was a hollow nothingness. And I wanted the knowledge, and they're like, oh, but we'll teach you the knowledge after our next workshop. And the great thing is we have nothing to upsell. At every workshop, we teach you what you need to know. There's no one in the back of the room trying to sell you some next big get-rich-quick, walk-on-hot-coals product. It's literally, we teach you the brass tacks, the specific stuff that you need to know to learn how to start and grow a business. And I encourage you to not believe what I'm saying, and I want you to Google the Z66 Auto Auction. I want you to Google Elephant in the Room. Look at Robert Zellner and Associates. Look them up and say, are they successful because they're geniuses, or are they successful because they have a proven system? When you do that research, you will discover that the same systems that we use in our own business can be used in your business. Come to Tulsa, book a ticket, and I guarantee you it's going to be the best business workshop ever, and we'll even give you your money back if you don't love it. We've built this facility for you, and we're excited to see you.
And now you may be thinking, what does it actually cost to attend an in-person two-day interactive Thrive Time Show business workshop? Well, good news. The tickets are $250 or whatever price that you can afford. What? Yes, they're $250 or whatever price you can afford. I grew up without money, and I know what it's like to live without money. So if you're out there today and you want to attend our in-person two-day interactive business workshop, all you got to do is go to ThriveTimeShow.com to request those tickets. And if you can't afford $250, we have scholarship pricing available to make it affordable for you.
I learned at the Academy, Kings Point in New York, acta non verba. Watch what a person does, not what they say.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. Robert Kiyosaki, the Rich Dad Radio Show. Today I'm broadcasting from Phoenix, Arizona, not Scottsdale, Arizona. They're close, but they're completely different worlds. And we have a special guest today. Definition of intelligence is, if you agree with me, you're intelligent. And so this gentleman is very intelligent. I've done this show before also, but very seldom do you find somebody who lines up on all counts And so Mr. Clay Clark is a friend of a good friend, Eric Trump. But we're also talking about money, bricks, and how screwed up the world can get in a few and a half hour. So Clay Clark is a very intelligent man, and there's so many ways we could take this thing. But I thought, since you and Eric are close, Trump, what were you saying about what Trump can't, what Donald, who's my age, and I can say or cannot say?
First of all, I have to honor you, sir. I want to show you what I did to one of your books here. There's a guy by the name of Jeremy Thorne, who was my boss at the time. I was 19 years old, working at Faith Highway. I had a job at Applebee's, Target, and DirecTV. And he said, "Have you read this book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad?" And I said, "No." And my father, may he rest in peace, he didn't know these financial principles. So I started reading all of your books and really devouring your books. And I went from being an employee to self-employed to the business owner to the investor. And I owe a lot of that to you. And I just wanted to take a moment to tell you thank you so much for allowing me to achieve success. And then I'll tell you all about Eric Trump. But I just want to tell you thank you, sir, for changing my life.
But not only that, Clay, you know, thank you, but you've become an influencer. You know, more than anything else, you've evolved into an influencer where your word has more and more power. So that's why I congratulate you on becoming. Because as you know, there's a lot of fake influencers out there, too, or bad influencers.
Yeah.
So anyway, I'm glad you and I agree so much. And thanks for reading my books.
Yeah.
That's the greatest thrill for me today. Not a thrill, but recognition is when people, young men especially, come up and say, "I read your book, changed my life. I'm doing this, I'm doing this, I'm doing this."
I learned at the Academy, Kings Point in New York, acta non verba. Watch what a person does, not what they say. Whoa.
Hey, I'm Ryan Wimpy. I'm originally from Tulsa, born and raised here. I went to a small private liberal arts college and got a degree in business. And I didn't learn anything like they're teaching here. I didn't learn linear workflows. I learned stuff that I'm not using and I haven't been using for the last 9 years. So what they're teaching here is actually way better than what I got at business school. And I went what was actually ranked as a very good business school. The linear workflow for us in getting everything out on paper and documented is really important. Like we have workflows that are kind of all over the place. Having linear workflow and seeing that mapped out on multiple different boards is pretty awesome. That's really helpful for me. The atmosphere here is awesome. I definitely just stared at the walls figuring out how to make my facility look like this place. This place rocks. It's invigorating. The walls are super, it's just very cool. The atmosphere is cool. The people are nice. It's a pretty cool place to be. Very good learning atmosphere. I literally want to model it and steal everything that's here at this facility and basically create it just on our business side.
Once I saw what they were doing, I knew I had to get here at the conference. This is probably the best conference or seminar I've ever been to in over 30 years in business.
You're not bored. You're awake, alive the whole time. It's not pushy. They don't try to sell you a bunch of things.
I was looking to learn how to just get control of my life, my schedule, and just get control of the business.
Planning your time, breaking it all down, making time for the F6 in your life, and just really implementing it and sticking with the program.
It's really lively. They're pretty friendly, helpful, and very welcoming.
I attended a conference a couple months back, and it was really the best business conference I've ever attended.
At the workshop, I learned a lot about time management. I'm really prioritizing what's the most important.
Biggest takeaways are, you want to take a step-by-step approach to your business. Whether it's marketing, what are those three marketing tools that you want to use, to human resources.
Some of the most successful people and successful businesses in this town, their owners were here today because they wanted to know more from Clay, and I found that to be kind of fascinating.
The most valuable thing that I've learned is diligence, that businesses don't change overnight. It takes time and effort, and you got to go through the ups and downs of getting it to where you want to go.
He actually gives you the roadmap out. I was stuck, didn't know what to do, and he gave me the roadmap out step by step.
We've set up systems in the business that make my life much easier, allow me some time freedom.
Here you can ask any question you want, they guarantee it'll be answered.
This conference motivates me and also give me a lot of knowledge and tools.
It's up to you to do it. Everybody can
do these things. They're stuff that everybody knows, but if you don't do it, nobody else can do it for you.
I can see the marketing working. And it's just an approach that makes sense.
Probably the most notable thing is just the income increase that we've had.
Everyone's super fun. It's super motivating. I've been here before, but I'm back again because it motivates me.
Your competition's going to come eventually or try to pick up these tactics. So you better, if you don't, somebody else will.
I'm Rachel with Tip Top Canine, and we just want to give a huge thank you to Clay and Vanessa Clark.
Hey guys, I'm Ryan with Tip Top Canine. Just want to say a big thank you to Thrive 15. Thank you to Make Your Life Epic. We love you guys, we appreciate you, and really just appreciate how far you've taken us.
This is our old house, right? This is where we used to live 2 years ago. This is our old neighborhood. See? It's nice, right?
So this is my old van and our old school marketing, and this is our old team. And by team, I mean it's me and another guy.
This is our new house with our new neighborhood.
This is our new van with our new marketing. And this is our new team. We went from 4 to 14, and I took this beautiful photo. We worked with several different business coaches in the past, and they were all about helping Ryan sell better and just teaching sales, which is awesome, but Ryan is a really great salesman. So we didn't need that. We needed somebody to help us get everything that was in his head out into systems, into manuals and scripts, and actually build a team. So now that we have systems in place, we've gone from 1 to 10 locations in only a year.
In October 2016, we grossed 13 grand for the whole month. Right now it's 2018, the month of October. It's only the 22nd. We've already grossed a little over 50 grand for the whole month, and we still have time to go. We're just thankful for you, thankful for Thrive and your mentorship, and we're really thankful that you guys have helped us to grow a business that we run now instead of the business running us. Just thank you, thank you, thank you, times a thousand.
So we really just want to thank you, Clay, and thank you, Vanessa, for everything you've done, everything you've helped us with. We love you guys.
If you decide to not attend the Thrive Time Workshop, you're missing out on a great opportunity.
The atmosphere at Clay's office is very lively. You can feel the energy as soon as you walk through the door, and it really got me and my team very excited.
If you decide not to come, you're missing out on an opportunity to grow your business, bottom line.
Love the environment. I love the way that Clay presents and teaches. It's a way that not only allows me to comprehend what's going on, but he explains it in a way to where it just makes sense.
The SEO optimization, branding, marketing, I've learned more in the last 2 days than I have the entire 4 years of college.
The most valuable thing that I've learned, marketing is key. Marketing is everything.
Making sure that you're branded accurately and clearly.
How to grow a business using Google reviews, and then just how to optimize our name through our website also.
Helpful with a lot of marketing, search engine optimization, helping us really rank high in Google.
The biggest thing I needed to learn was how to build my foundation, how to systemize everything and optimize everything, build my SEO.
How to become more organized. More efficient.
How to make sure the business is really there to serve me as opposed to me constantly being there for the business.
New ways of advertising my business as well as recruiting new employees.
Group interviews, number one. Before we felt like we were held hostage by our employees. Group interviews has completely eliminated that because you're able to really find the people that would really be the best fit.
Hands on how to hire people, how to deal with human resources, a lot about marketing and overall just how to structure the business, how it works for me, and also then how that can translate into working better for my clients.
The valuable thing I've learned here is time management.
I like the 1 hour of doing your business is real critical if I'm going to grow and change.
Clay really teaches you how to navigate through those things and not only find freedom, but find your purpose in your business and find the purposes for all those other people that directly affect your business as well.
Everybody.
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 Everyone needs to attend the conference because you get an opportunity to see that it's real.